In the United States, for the amount of housing that we need, we're actually short of over 5 million homes. But have no fear, Elon Musk is here. I would like to introduce to you the Tesla home. We're going to be taking a closer look at that Tesla home, but he's not the only billionaire that's throwing his hat in the ring to figure out how we can build more houses more efficiently. All right, now let's talk about Elon's Tesla house. The thing about it is, just like anything with Elon, who knows if this is actually going to be a thing, but they do actually have a Tesla home that is traveling all across Australia and is being powered by 100% renewable energy. When you take a look inside, it's just basically a little tiny house. There's nothing extraordinary about it. Of course, they have their signature Tesla solar panels right on the top, but they're using this as like a demo. So basically, this is just a publicity stunt for their Tesla homes and that you can use renewable energy for a house and for your car and travel across the United States or any other country for that matter. A subscriber had sent this to me thinking that this would be the thing that changed the world because, you know, Elon has his hands in everything. And a lot of people have confused Elon Musk's Tesla house with another company that's making tiny homes because they had talked about Elon living in a $50,000 modular tiny home at SpaceX. This is a completely different house, not to be confused with the ones that you've seen probably a million videos on. I might have even done a couple of those. But if Elon Musk was to get in the whole housing game like he's trying to hint at right now, I think that it wouldn't necessarily be what you think it's going to be. Elon Musk isn't really known for inventing. People always kind of get that confused. What he actually does is he invests in companies that make things. He usually has a small percentage in that company, but his name's on there because he's so recognizable. In many cases, like in PayPal, after a while, they're like, you can go. But he's not the inventor of Tesla. He's not the inventor of PayPal. And I don't think he's going to be the inventor of these homes either. He's just a man that has a lot of money that it can invest in these really cool companies. No matter how you feel about Elon Musk, he likes to get his name in the press, and this is just one more way he can do it. If he was really going to get into the housing game, I cannot imagine that his houses would fall into that affordable housing category. His Tesla shingles are not cheap, not cheap at all. It will be interesting if Elon decides to take over a company that makes housing and what kind of company he will do, because you know he never does anything that is in the box. It would be completely out of the box. Or maybe he'll invest in those monolithic dome homes. I really wish he would do that because those are super structurally sound and not many people are doing them. Listen to me, I know what I'm talking about. But there are other billionaires that are in the housing sectors that are doing some things that are legitimate and they're available on the market right now. You might even know who this guy is right here. Do you recognize these type of homes? How about these over here? How do you really feel about these types of homes? But if you were going to take the advice from anybody, would you take the advice of a billionaire like Warren Buffett? Well, he owns Clayton Homes, and all those houses that you just saw are things that came off of his company's lot. He's been investing in manufactured homes since 2003. Even though they may be profitable and very reliable homes, Warren Buffett doesn't have the best reputation when it comes to manufactured housing. There's numerous news articles talking about how Warren Buffett's Clayton Homes preys on the most vulnerable people trying to buy a home. Their claims are that Clayton Homes makes more mobile home loans than any other competitor by 6, which doesn't necessarily seem like a bad thing, except that Clayton Homes operates under about 18 different names. So if they're under 18 different names, it makes you think that you're not buying a Clayton home, you're buying a different type of product altogether, but it's under the same umbrella. Not only that, it's been reported that some of the interest rates can go as high as 15% when people could have qualified for an interest rate that was much, much lower. A lot of their previous clients from Clayton Homes say they did have predatory lending practices used against them, where the salesperson was steering them to use their specific lender that's in their office. That's why I always tell you, if you were looking at a manufactured home on a brand new lot, go ahead and talk to their finance department, but don't sign anything. Make sure you shop around to local banks like credit unions and see if you can get a much better deal. That's why a lot of manufactured home companies don't like me talking about them, because they know I tell you to do that because I want you to get a better deal, a much better interest rate. Nobody needs to be paying 15% on a manufactured home. Unless your credit is terrible and you want to get yourself at least 2 to 3 different quotes from different banks if you're considering to do this. But back to Warren Buffett. In 2016, Clayton Homes delivered over 42,000 units. Buffett was also quoted as saying that Clayton's focus will always be on manufactured homes, which account for 70% of new American homes costing less than $150,000. And that is pretty smart. He's had some pretty negative press. So whether you like Warren Buffett or not, he's definitely filling a need, which is we need more affordable housing in the United States. And he's not the only one that has been saying it. Even the Biden administration came out with a plan just recently, about 2 months ago, talking about how they were going to start incorporating manufactured housing to get more affordable units across the United States. But In That Plane, it isn't just about manufactured housing. It was also about modular construction as well. All right, we're going to take a little step back and I'm going to show you something that's pretty cool. I just got off this call with this guy from Sonderpods, and it's a company that's making little tiny houses behind your house, like an ADU. But these are houses. They're not like built to any other standard than you would with a traditional built home. They're just smaller. They're just tiny little houses. And he said that I could show you guys the inside with a 3D tour. So I'm going to show you really quick. All right, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Look at this. Loading Panama Ram. Ooh, look at that. Look it. You can go into each and every room and you can like move the little 3D thing all the way around. There's their kitchen. But as you can tell, it's like it is a full house. And they're compliant with all the codes that are required in California. That being said, if you are outside the state, they're not building them for anywhere else but California. I just wanted to show you these really quick because they're super cute and super cool. But they have the full finishes you would put on a traditional built home. Now, let me introduce you to a billionaire you probably never heard of. His name is Nick Mowbray. To me, if you took Elon Musk and shook him up with Warren Buffett, that's what you get is Nick Mowbray. But he started off making a company called Zuru, which made toys. And he took that knowledge of producing toys in a factory and put it into housing. His whole mission and dream for affordable housing now is to take those same ideas of production. And that's where he came up the idea of why couldn't we do this for housing? His whole goal is to build the most affordable homes that you've ever seen. And he wants to build them to the code that would suit any country, the highest building standards, according to him. He's quoted as saying, "The craziest thing that we're going to be able to do is build a house for a tiny fraction of the cost of what you pay today. Our cost will be less than 1/10 of what you build a home for today. And it'll probably be dramatically less than that at a minimum." He said that his robots that are going to be making these houses are going to be making everything, all the way down to the finishes. And the concept of building your home, instead of building it with an architect, you would be doing it on a computer screen, just like you would with like the Sims game. That is his whole concept. And the guy has been recognized across the world for his concept. And he said that he's going to be able to do it. I'm very, very, very hopeful. But if you take a look at some of the houses that he's already designed, it looks like he's making homes that no one would ever even imagine were made by robots in a factory. Mowbray asserts the houses will be built to the world's strictest building codes. You know, with all these three billionaires, do you know what I find is super interesting? That every single one of them is interested in building some kind of modular production line home. Something I've been saying that needed to be done for the last 5 years. My dad always said, if you're going to make a wise investment, follow the people that have more money than you and see what they're investing in. And it looks like modular construction is one of the things they're all looking at. So who are you rooting for? Are you rooting for Nick, Warren, or Elon? Let me know in the comments section below. And speaking of investing in modular construction, you may want to invest some more time in learning about it by watching these videos right here. My name is Kristina Smallhorn, your real estate whisperer, and I tell you all this because good real estate information matters, and you don't have to be a billionaire to know that.